We give you what you give us in worshiping you. The testimonies who are here are glorified.
We
worship, praise, and sing. Let our worship be passed through giving. Because of the offertory, thanksgiving, and tithe. Open the windows of heaven and bless us. Fight against whatever we want to take our
hands.
Let your mercy work upon us every day. Enlarge the territories of our income. Do great and amazing things. Fight for us, O God. Protect us from dying and being
led.
We stand firm to do your duty. So that our works may fight for us
tomorrow.
We be glorified for the
Lord.
In the name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you. Oh, I'm coming. Oh, I'm coming. Stirring up the fire that was set in their hearts. We ask you to be the fulfillment of everything. The name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Please have your seats in the mighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I first repent. Sylvia was singing. The Holy Spirit told me to give her 10,000. But I failed to get the energy to pull out the 10,000 from my pocket. I'm in a season of loving money. And I need money so much. But I repent, come and keep your 10,000. The Spirit has convicted me. But I couldn't get the energy to pull out the 10,000 to give it to you. So I repent.
Hallelujah.
But you see that we are suffering for nothing. Those who don't obey the Holy Spirit are suffering for nothing. If I could have continued stating the voice, Could I get this refund of 10,000?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, Shemene,
I am very happy.
We hope you message the Zabandi.
Without living alone, refusing to give money.
Okshanga mchiruhu.
To see that you still stand.
Mazumbile kwenye.
I have spent many period of time without coming together with you here. It's not because I don't love you, or maybe I didn't want you, but there is a season for everything. I saw an international singer here, but she sang in English. Me, I will sing in Runyankore.
Yes,
I have seen we are two singers in this place that are on top of all the people. The brother who was coming here to who was singing in the time of testimony, the song was in English, I didn't understand. He's the first and I'm the second. Let me start my song.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. My song goes this way and has the theme of the word that we are going to share today.
It
says that don't be anxious, because you with Jesus made a covenant. There is a covenant that was made between God and Jesus in 2,000 years back. There is a covenant that Jesus signed, and he signed it before the Father of all creatures. When God was there, he got a mindset. He thought about something and said, the people I created, in my image, I see the devil taking them far away from me. What can I do? Because I'm angry at
them,
and I cannot forgive them without doing anything. I cannot bring them back to myself. Yet there is nothing has been done. What can I do next? For all those that are here, who loves me and can do for me this desire to bring back my people that the devil stole from me. When he made that statement, who loves me? There are four creatures that always worship before your throne, saying, You're holy,
You're holy.
And they were amazed about this statement. Who loves me? If we don't raise our hands, can this man say we are lying? And the four creatures raised their arms on high. And there were 24 elders. They were like these ones sitting here. I see people strong in church government. We are in the time of church government. And the 24 elders raised up their arms. Has there the angels also raised their hands? And the army of heaven also raised their hands. He said, do you love me? Now you are going to bring back my people. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus Christ was closer by beside him. He also raised his hand. Now he told them three things. The first one, the person who has to bring these people has pulled down all the authority and come back from the authority of God and be born as a person and be like a young baby and be bathed in a basin like a child. And after you bring back my people, I say, oh. And your mind could say, this is impossible. Me, the army commander, the one that leads the army of heaven, to put everything down and become a child and close in the body of those who sin. That cannot be. Michael put down the hands. And the second thing, the one is going to bring back these people. I was so angry when someone sinned. Now my anger, this person must put down the blood. After shedding the blood, my anger will be seized. And this person will restore my people back to me.
Said, okay.
Now the four creatures put down their hands. He said the sad thing is going to die and go to the cross and be nailed, and they will crown him with thorns, and after that they will bury him, even his grave. They will put a big stone that that person can never come back. The 24 elders were closed. The hands were down. Then after a time, he found out that only Jesus had risen his hand.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Bible says I was silent, for 6 hours in heaven. In that silence, God was asking himself, I knew that amongst these people there was someone that could go. But the coming back of a restoration of a person has gone directly to the point and touched my heart. The only begotten Son is the one who has raised his hand. He kept
shouting.
He asked what to do and he failed to get it. But because he's the one that started it, he said, okay, I've accepted you can go. But we are going to make a covenant. Wherever I say, if you are going to do them and fulfill them, that's when I will release you to go. Is a question saying, what is salvation? What is salvation? Many people in this season, They get salvation and mix it with other things. And they mix it with religion. They mix it with other stuff. But salvation is something that can stand for itself. Because in the middle of a person and God, there is a covenant called serving. But Jesus said before the Father of all
angels,
that say that I have accepted all to go and serve a person. I want us to understand the meaning of salvation. Because there are questions that they ask us. They ask you that what is your religion? And you say that your religion is salvation.
Yes, no.
Right, you're right. Because a religion is a language.
Group.
But in English it's called a group. And in Unyankole means religion also. Praise the Lord. Now, salvation is not an association. Salvation is not anything else. But there was an assignment between God and Jesus. They made a covenant saying that I'm going to descend and save a person. And all the anger you had about that person, I want you to impose it unto me. And Jesus sent for your anger and sent your enmity and sent for your death and sent for your cross. And after he posed them to himself and he prayed for them and you remain without any judgment, you came from the things you are in and came back to God. Because all things that have refused you to meet God had gone away. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now
salvation. I want to ask you today, accept the word salvation. There are people that take things for granted. They tell you they are born again. They don't understand being born again. There are these children of boss. I asked them, I found them greeting, praise the Lord. They even don't know if the food they have eaten was brought by God. And you ask yourself, they are thanking God in which manner? Now where are they getting, praise the Lord? They even don't know why they are thanking God. Praise the Lord. But they are under the grace of their Father. Praise the Lord. Before you thank God, first know the reason why. Appreciate thanking God and greeting. We have good, how are you? And how are you? And how are you? People greet in different languages. But praise the Lord. In the languages of God, where is it found? I'm not saying not great, praise the Lord. But greet it with a purpose. Just know that this is the time to thank God. We should not mix up salvation and mix it with other things.
Hallelujah.
Salvation, what does it mean? Salvation means there was something that had held them. And there was a savior that came and saved you from that. That was almost killing you. When you are going to be called, it means there is something that squeezed you somewhere. Let me speak this in Nyarwanda. I even don't know Nyankole very well. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There is something we call
to
squeeze. there's something that had squeezed you
somewhere.
And in a manner of squeezing you, you try to raise up your hand and
fail.
And when it failed in the mixture of
confusion,
there came someone else
that
saved you from that which was on top of you. And after that, your life was relieved. That is what we call salvation. If you are here, you are called the saved person. And to be Moroko is a Uganda word. It comes from a word to be saved. You know, in Yankore, it is to be saved. And in Nyarwanda, it is also to be saved. No one can be saved from something that had not tormented them. No one can be saved from something that they had failed to do. If you're here and you are saved, I want you to press back. If you want to jump, you cannot jump that rope. You go backwards and see how you jump that level that they have put before you. I have come to tell you about the word salvation. I want you to go back and understand the thing that the Lord saved you from. If you find that there's something that I've not
remembered,
and you understand that the enemies you have, you still have one more, and you strengthen yourself. And you strengthen yourself. Now, salvation. Let us not call it any other thing. Salvation comes with later. Because we have to listen. And after being listened, we are called. And when we are called, we answer. And after being answering, the one who has called you, what do you do?
What is the next step?
Hallelujah.
Why
you have been called. You have heard.
You
have come. And after coming and arriving, what is next? After salvation, what comes next? The problem we have as people, when we finish being saved, we understand that we have entered something. Then we understand. But today I have come to tell you, that which you have, don't be satisfied. Don't be satisfied with the level you are. If you have come from that sit there, don't be satisfied. If you're from that sitting there, don't be satisfied. And if you've come from there to here, don't be satisfied. Every day think about what you are. Well, how long will it last? When will this last? How long will this last? What does this need? Every day. Every morning. Every night, every evening, ask yourself about the things you're in. When will I continue in these things? What do I need to continue with this? What do I need to protect what I entered into? And after reaching into it, what do I need to maintain it? When we come to the history of Gehazi, the scriptures are going to come. He was a cold person. And he was a very good minister. What shows that he was good? One day in Shinem, a woman did a very good thing for them.
Elisha wanted to do a miracle. He asked that, what should we do for this woman? Should I announce you to be the first in the government? And the
president in
the woman said, the president is my maternal uncle. Should I go to the things of riches? He said, if I don't sign in Bank of Uganda, they cannot give it to me. Elisha said, what should I do for you according to what you've done for us?
There
has had a revelation before Elisha had gotten what to do. He said that this woman, since she had never got a baby boy, if you could do that for him, because I know you're able to do it.
Number one,
the first thing, when someone calls you, when you answer, come closer to
him,
listen to what they need. Before you go, that they have
said
to you, first listen to what they need. The second thing, understand the person. Understand the one that has called you. When God finished sending His Son Jesus Christ, so that He can serve us, 400 years had gone and passed by. When God had no peace with human, one who had died, the one that had remained, God put a mark unto that person. When he was making a statement, he said, I cannot go. God said, go. You have been released.
You have been cast.
You will not stay in this earth of my people. The second thing, the one who will meet you, whoever meets you will kill you. And Cain went. When he had reached here, he said, no. For your God that no one can answer you back. That is a very, very big punishment. If you say that whoever meets me kills me, I will not go any further. Now kill me, or else I will not live here. And God said, no, I have changed my mind. I have put a mark onto you. Go.
Or quit.
The one who kills you will be revenged 7 times. Now Cain said, okay. Now chasing me and giving me life, no problem with that. Many people, we have sticked on God without purpose, but because we have life, yet we don't have eternal life. When they put a mark onto the forehead of
Cain,
God looked for all the marks. He found a mark to put on the forehead of Cain so that they cannot kill him. And that mark that was put into Cain, they called an image of the devil and imposed it onto the forehead of Cain, so that the devil has his the father of the killer. No one will kill the person who has a
father.
Whoever will meet him with the image of the devil will never kill that person, but will leave because he has the image of his
master.
All murderers were under the devil because he came with his
manifesto.
He came with three things. He came from heaven. He came to kill, to steal, and to destroy. If you are here and a thief of time, and a thief of time, that's how you have a mark of the devil and that image of the devil. And you hear you're a killer, a murderer. You may not have cut anyone's
name,
but you're a killer in your heart.
Indirectly,
you kill in the heart, but you don't kill directly. If you're here and you get a person,
and you go and gossip about them and speak about them, just know you have killed that person. The Bible in the book of Proverbs says that there are six or seven things that I don't like,
which are abominable before me,
that are abominable before me. One, the voice and the language that makes people fight. That is an abomination before God. When you're doing that, just know you have an image of the devil on your forehead. When Jesus had it, I'm talking about salvation. If you could accept today, you could love salvation. Salvation. When Jesus came, he spoke these words. I've been given authority in heaven and the earth. When you stay in me, and my word stay in you. What does that mean? He wanted that God had put the image of the devil unto Cain, that also after he had come to save, should have the image of Jesus. Praise the Lord. If you are saved today, just know that God, the one that got the image of the devil and put it unto the forehead of Cain. Cain was on the seam of all of us. This is why there was an enmity between man and God. But what we call salvation,
yes,
when Jesus came,
he
got the image of God. Because it's the one that was separated from, he brought it back unto the past. Everyone who was saved has a man that is the image of God. Has you had disobeyed? Has the one who had disobeyed was given a symbol of the image of the devil? If you do the things of the devil and you have not been transformed to do the things of God, just know you have the image of the devil on your forehead. Praise the Lord. When God was creating a person, he said, let us create man in our own image. If you know that you gave your life to Jesus, there is an image of God that has spent 400 years. When a person did it happen, that Jesus brought, when he raised from the dead, they wanted to touch him. He said, don't touch me. Let me first go to heaven. What did he mean? I first go and get the image of God back that Adam and Eve had given to the devil. And the devil stayed with it 400 years. And he came and removed it from him. And took away the beauty of the person that God had put in the person. He said, don't touch me before I go to heaven. Let me first take the image of God back and give it to him. And then later, he will give it to whoever he wishes to give. Because Jesus couldn't do it again, to do a first mystery, that he can get the image of God and bring it and give it to a person first. But he gave it to God, the honor, so that in the time due, when you are born, you and me, that we say we are born again, and giving our life to Jesus, then you can get our own and put it to you. If we are praying in that way, not standing in the image of God, it means that the death of Christ has because what he fought for, he still has it.
So he is
still waiting for the person to believe so that he can give him the image. For you in a way that you are not having the image of God. It's because you have not known what is salvation. But salvation is going back to the original image of God. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We are going to the book of Genesis chapter 1 verses 26. And also read Genesis chapter 2 verse 7. And write the 2 Chronicles chapter 15 verses 15 to 16. And then go to the book of Genesis 3:13. You will read when you are home. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Should I read for you again? Genesis chapter 1 verses 26. Genesis 2 verses 7. 2 Chronicles chapter 15 verses 15 to 16. And then Genesis 3 verses 3. Praise the Lord Jesus. Salvation. I want to explain about it because of time.
Abraham
got one problem. When they called him, they told him to leave his nation. And he left. But before they called him, in the house of Terah, his father, where he used to worship his God. They were staying in
Aran.
It was the nation of the Allah worshippers. And Terah was born in that same nation of people who worship demons. When time came,
Abraham,
who was called Abram, which means to
the disaster days.
To die premature, yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And then later, when they had left Abraham, that they had put a name, which means he will not live longer. And there was a shrine for the spirits they used to worship. There were three gods.
Abraham.
Got an axe. And entered into the shrine of his father Terah. And got the middle of God. He cut both arms. Got the young God. Cut his neck. Got the axe and put in a rope and put it in the neck of the big God. When the father came back, asked him, when they are going to worship, they found all things cut. He said, Abraham, what killed and what happened to my gods? He said, I don't know. But what I know, I thought I heard them quarreling. And the big God asking
them,
don't you know that I'm your
husband?
Why despising
you?
As in the way he was fighting, the Kayanga God also came to fight on behalf of this. This is why the big God cut his hands. And Terah asked, the trees we cut from heaven, forest, and brought them, they are the ones you heard speaking. And Abraham said, hey, Father, the things we have worshipped, we call God.
These
trees we cut, they are not God. That is from Genesis chapter
12.
And it says that immediately in the heaven,
The voice of Abraham said, Abraham, come from the house of your father. Come from your nation. Come from your
family.
With your father and mother. I'm going to make you a nation.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There are things we found at home worshiping that have sticked to our
lives.
The things we call salvation. We will first look for word of God. I enter into your heart. Before you go anywhere. Before you go to preach. Before you go to the crusade. That is the word of God.
And
start cutting. And after cutting them, you remain yourself
there.
And after you remove yourself, Jesus takes the place. That is what they call salvation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Abraham, which is with you.
The problem Abraham had, when he was coming from his nation, he went to his rod. One was not called by God. If you could be here, there is something that you have
known
in a nation. In the things of salvation which is
God.
Go and quarrel with it today. The Bible says
it
spent 25 years. When Abraham has not heard anything from God. Because of two reasons.
One,
he came with rot. He broke the images that were in the house that they used to worship in. But he never broke the house. The house was there. He cut the things that were
doing.
But the house was still standing. What was the name of
that?
Even the people who remained here, they brought other gods. Because the shrine was
there.
They brought the other gods. The more you cut the things in you, the more you leave the things you and remain in yourself. And remain the daughter to the
child.
That your son to the
God.
And move in the norms of
God.
When you are still moving in the things of the system of
God.
And feeling the things of this world sweet. That means that you are the worshiping place is still there. That shrine that is there. The Bible says in the book of God. That when the demons leave a person, they stay for a while. They come back. When they find that the house is
sold,
and they found the house
is sold,
they go back. And remember as I came
in,
and I've stayed there randomly, that I've stayed there without a house shelter that came from a people. And then people refused to access me. When they find the house of God, they said, you are suffering from here. Come and go with me. I have a house where I can go. I find where the house is now. The demons come. That are greater than the one
you have.
Seven times. And they stay in you. To leave the worshiping place. Made Abraham to stay 25 years without hearing the voice of God, without seeing God. But I thank God that one day there was quarrel between the herdsmen of Lot and Abraham. There was fighting. And Abraham said,
Lot,
this world is big. Choose where you go. Leave from where you go. But let us be separated. The Bible says that after being separated, God revealed himself to Abraham. Down the tree. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm asking you today. If you are gonna come with
God,
there are things you carried in salvation and brought from your clan,
from your nation, from your religion, from where you worship from, and you came with, and you have never left the
mountain.
I ask the God of heaven that today there should be a square between you with that which you
have.
There should be a square between you and your, and there should be a quarreling. There should be arguments between you and the things that stick to
it.
There should be more arguments between you and the thing that had blocked you. There should be quarreling. There should be separation. The one they call Asa, you found him in the book of Chronicles. He was a king. He did good things. He called all the Israel. They killed all the gods. They pulled out all the enemies. In the positions of others, they put one god. But Asa had a mother. And the mother was
mad.
And she was the leader of demon worshipping. Now Asa was settling the nation. But in his home with the mother, there were images that were worshipped. One day Asa said, but this man of mine, I'm going to chase her from the kingdom. And I'm going to cut her gods. Now the mother had that information. That what Asa has done to the nation. That we have no false prophets. We don't have bad
images.
And we had the news that is coming to your home also. When she was there, Asa came. Said, number one, you are not the mother to
me.
Where you begot to me. But you are not my mother. You will not say what to be had in the nation. Get out of the palace. As he was going out, he got him at the back head and pushed and cut down all the images of worship. Asa went and left the house. I asked you today, let us break down the house, the shrine, and go back and break down the houses. When that house remains of the mother to other, when you read that Bible verse, he made a covenant with the people that
he had given,
because he had left
the house.
I ask you today, if there is a house that remains, if there is a house that remains, you may have given your life to Jesus and left the denomination of the
Catholics,
the religion of the Protestants. You left the religion of the Muslims and the ones of the witch doctors and say, I've given my life to Jesus. But there is a house. Your friend, when they are going to be baptized, come and give thanks for me. I'm going to baptize my children. You go there and baptize those children. And you
fast.
And you give. And in the morning they tell you, my children are going to be. And you also go there. We have the Thanksgiving of Mother's Union. Even on Sunday, don't
pray.
You left the religion. You left the norms of religion. What Jesus that say they speak God with their mouth, but their hearts, they are far away from
me.
You left all that. But the Thanksgiving of Mother's Union, you cannot pray at your church. You are going to go and give thanks for Mother's Union. Mother's Union, what does it mean? Go and search about it. Where did it come from? And for you gave your life, so you cannot worship him. That is the image that came from Mother Mary is blessed woman.
Hey. nguisa kuchire. Bonga na ba ni malinga ba habush.
Now I'm talking about the houses, the
structures.
Now after destroyed all the forbidden
things,
and it chased the mother from the palace, but the house of the mother remained. It became
a
trap, like Abraham also had
come,
but he left the shrine. The problem why we are not
in the Jerusalem,
we have left our shrines
where we go.
And we go back and visit
him
because we have not destroyed
him.
But I argue today, differentiate salvation and other things. Differentiate what is in you and what you are built. If you want to be saved, if you want to be saved, shift completely. There's what they call shifting. And there is also what they call changing position. And there is shifting and changing the position of the home. To change the position of the home, they can have some. You stay in a place for a long time. When people had no medicine, they shift the house from here
to another.
So that in this same crowd, the cow shouldn't get problems. They go and build them. And as they are going, they get the cup they used to use for the urine of cows. They go with it. You left this cup. Where do you get the urine from now? Now the rats that used to be there in the
island,
they move through slowly by slowly. And after some period, the rats are in a new place. The cat they had left in the
island,
they also come and visit the rats and see where the customers are now. That is just
position.
I'm saying we come out of salvation of just repositioning. We should not come from the Protestant, from the Catholics, repositioning from the
Muslims,
from our ancestors, from the shrines, and then position it here in being born again. And they ask you, where are they pray from? We don't see you these days. I pray living faith. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. In the evening tomorrow, we have to dedicate children. They are going to be dedicated to the Lord. Come and be there. Just know that you are going back to the old things. You have gone back to the old things. To go there and lay hands. You, my friend, come and stand beside my children. The morning you are going to be standing on behalf of that child. The Bible says that person is cast the one who stands on behalf of another person. Because you are closer to the place where you should
go.
You have not gone far. Now, children of God, if we want to
save,
let us understand the meaning of salvation and shift. Shifting. Me, I was born here in
Kanyariyeho,
but now I stay in
Chiriandongo.
I had here Chiriandongo person like
you.
You always say that I'm a person from other nations, but I have a brother here. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But I shifted. I went and stayed where? And stayed there. I bought there. Before I left here, I used to bring people to dig for me. They steal me. I stay a man. One day, I met Chilman. He said, where do you stay? I said, I went this
way.
Who did you ask? How did you go? Go into jail. You go back.
where he shifted from. He said, go. Those who die but for the stomach. I thank God who took me there and I never died. Praise the Lord. But I'm asking you the salvation.
Be
stay far away from the place you
should be.
Stay and shift far away from
the place.
And go far. So that
your rat
may not go there and meet you again. Where your cat will not meet you again. What has the cut
mean?
The anger you had before salvation. That is your cut. The cut is a Nyarwanda
one.
But in Nyakwa is Kappa.
I don't know Kappa, Puss.
But Banyarwanda call it Injangwe.
Injangwe.
The Banyarwanda say that it was
a slave leopard
now what means your card to meet you where you have gone in a new place. Those are the boy you see and say, be before salvation. Those things could not
understand.
And I am informing you.
Why you don't let you?
Because salvation that opens to
me.
Yes, so they are not far away. But the cat visited them. Stand on your feet. The rat means to be a glutton. If you are in church and you gave your life to Jesus, that 100 is a hard thing to remove from
1,000.
100 is greater than the other 900. Your rat has visited you. You have not. You are not healed from gluttony. You are still the older person. Because the one you left in
your
visited you again because you didn't go far away.
You know what I'm saying? Yes. Okay. Yes.
You have not gone far away from religion. You have not gone far away, they cannot call you. They still see you in the same character you used to have. A person who has not gone far
away,
you must go. But the one who has left you, when you see them, just know that person who left and leave that
person.
When they are still calling you, just know you have not left them. You are still with them. But when you leave them, and go deep inside, and get the panga that is the
one,
and guide whatever will
say,
and break all the shrines, you will leave all those men and they will not call you back. The reason why they are calling is because they see closer to them. When you are not giving tithe, you still have your rat in the house. Because you are still stealing. The Bible says you are cursed because you are thieves. Now that truth, they don't want it today. The church doesn't
want it.
Because it is hard. Jesus stood before Pilate. Said, when you know the truth, the truth will set you
free.
And Pilate asked him, what is the truth?
Pilato yimukaho yaza kubuzo mukaze byanu.
Pilato went to ask the wife what she had to pray. He never knew what the truth was meaning. What is the truth?
What is truth?
When they ask you, what is the truth? What is the truth?
Indirect answer. Are you
there? Is there anyone?
Being what? Being open and transparent to everything. No, but good. What is truth? Why are you here? You have told me that you are a truth follower. What is truth? The fact that in spite of the fact that where's that matter? What is truth? It is something that you have said with integrity.
Integrity.
No, thank you. Yes.
Yeah,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Amazima.
What is the truth?
Amazima.
What is the truth?
Yes, Pilate kabuza Yesu.
Pilate asked Jesus.
Yam jatamazima.
What is the truth?
Yaba takamshobore.
Before he explained,
yaza kubuza mkaze
jato. Ask the wife what he had dreamed.
Amazima gatigaraga tamanyuwe.
And the truth was not to know.
Yesu bamba.
And Jesus was crucified because they didn't know the truth. This one had it indirect. And also another one got it indirect. The truth is the word of God. Jesus Christ.
Yes. Yes.
What is Jesus? The truth is God. When you know God, God will set you free. What is the word? The word is God. Because it came out
of God
and became a person. And that person from
the
was together with God. They created the heavens. They did everything. The truth is the word. And the truth is God. And God is the truth.
Come and see.
When we know God and know God, the time he invested and gave his only son and others failed and came to restore you back to him, you couldn't mix yourself in associations.
Protestant, a group formed by Martin Luther.
It is an association that was started by Martin Luther that was against the bad actions in the Catholic Church. They came with revival. They are good people, the Protestants. But when they came, they went back. They came from Vatican and built closer to Vatican and they continued following the norms in Vatican. Today the things that are in the Catholic Church are the ones that are in the Protestant
Church.
Because the first thing they were protesting about, they were the baptism of the water that is not in the Bible. When they were against it, they came back and Constantine was sick. The one who were protesting, they said what we should do. This person cannot go into water. Let us get water into
the
and put it in the
water.
This is why they
are
baptizing the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Stand with boldness to fight until
it reaches.
Never forget that there is salvation.
otarigero.
Don't forget. Go and listen closely when they ask. If they forget that, just know that they have lied to you. Stand fast with the devil until the day of
overcoming.
When you stand before the
church,
the one who judges the dead and the ones alive, on that day, and don't forget that there is salvation. Whatever you are doing, do it. Whatever you are doing, do it. But there is salvation. Close your eyes. Take 2 minutes listening. See that which you worship that is in you. See the houses that were built in you. Lamentations chapter 5 verse 7. Thou say there are sisters that sin and died and no more. But we carry the unrighteousness. Now say, oh Lord, today, what I came with,
I came with,
The Kahagatian Navio,
Habe Hentonga, Zabirahagatia Rotna Abraham, Oguatana, Hasokagakokamoyuri,
Nanyerizo,
the Kantanene,
Everybody,
God bless you.
Thank you.